Welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on light sensors. My name is Alex Bendari-Young, and I am an applications engineer at Texas Instruments. In this video, we will discuss testing of light sensors. As mentioned in the previous chapter, integrating a light sensor into your system often impacts the optics and performance of the sensor. Even when simulation is employed, testing in the system is typically needed to evaluate final performance. Testing may also be required to evaluate competing light sensor ICs under application-specific conditions, such as low light performance and rejection of near-infrared light. There are a number of optical challenges that need to be addressed to implement an accurate optical test setup, which is the topic of this video. In this video, we will discuss setups to measure accuracy, linearity, source variation, and angular response. The concepts presented can also be applied to extend the setup for other types of tests. In the most basic test, we want to measure the sensor accuracy at a specific light level. To do this, we need to shine light on the sensor and determine if the sensor is reporting the correct reading. This requires placing the light sensor in a room along with a light source. For initial testing, a common desk lamp can be used with an off-the-shelf LED or incandescent bulb. The first problem with this setup is that any ambient lighting will affect the sensor reading. This includes external lamps, displays, and sunlight through windows. This requires placing the sensor in a dark enclosure or dark room to ensure all ambient lighting is removed, as shown. Now we are able to shine the light and obtain a lux reading from the sensor. The next problem is how to know if the reading is correct. A reference meter is needed to know how much light is landing on the sensor. A lux meter can be purchased online and used to measure the correct light level. The next question is where to place the lux meter. Shining a light source onto a flat surface will create a circular spot where the light is shining. However, most light sources have poor uniformity with the spot unevenly illuminated. This means that different points in the spot will receive different amounts of light. If we move our lux meter around the spot as shown, we will see the reading changing. Even if the lux meter and light sensor are placed side by side, they will receive different amounts of light. The most foolproof way to solve this is to place the lux meter in the same location as the sensor in all three dimensions. This means that the lux meter and sensor need to be in the same position in X and Y, as well as the same distance from the source in Z. Now the lux meter reading and the sensor reading can be compared and accuracy determined for this light level. Now we have accounted for spatial variation in the light source, but need to also consider variation in time. Light sources are not stable in time. For example, the light level will vary with the temperature of the source. Especially when the source first turns on, there will be a warm-up time as the output intensity stabilizes, as seen in the plot. If the reading is taken on the lux meter and then changes by the time the reading for the sensor is taken, error will be introduced. To measure source stability, many readings over time can be taken from the lux meter. This data can be used to determine how much warm-up time is needed and how much error will be introduced. The setup now allows us to measure accuracy of the sensor at a single light level. However, accuracy may be needed at multiple light levels, such as to measure the low light linearity of the sensor. The intensity of the source could be changed a number of ways, like placing a filter in front of the light source. But a simpler way to change the level is to vary the supply current into the source. In this example, we show a dimmer used to vary the light level of our common desk lamp. While readily available, dimmers use pulse width modulation to vary the light level, which is not ideal. We will discuss improvements to this setup later on in this video. It is important to note that the output is not typically directly proportional to the current. Because of this and other factors, such as thermal stability, the reference meter is needed to check the light level at each intensity. Additionally, at each current setting, the source will typically stabilize to a different temperature. In this case, each intensity setting would need a wait time to stabilize, and then the reference meter would need to be checked. An example process for measuring linearity using this method is shown. As seen in the previous example, this process can be manual and time-consuming. To speed up this test, the reference can be moved to be side-by-side with the sensor. Now the reference will be getting a different light level from the sensor, and this difference needs to be compensated. Imagine we place the lux meter at two locations, first at the reference location, and then at the sensor location, as shown. At the sensor location, the meter reads 500 lux, and at the reference location, it reads 400 lux. We can calculate a compensation factor to multiply the reference location reading by to correct for this difference and get the lux level at the sensor location. In this case, we get 1.25 as the factor, as shown in the calculation. Now, when running the test, the compensated reference will give the actual sensor lux value, and the sensor accuracy can be determined as shown. This allows the reference and sensor to be read at the same time, improving the test time. So far, we have described test setups using the readily available desk lamp as our light source for easiest testing. However, there are a number of shortcomings that should be discussed. A lamp plugged into the wall outlet will vary over time due to the 60 Hz component from the wall outlet. Using a dimmer switch to vary the lamp current also introduces instability to the output. For these reasons, using a constant current DC power supply to drive an LED light source will give better results. The current on the LED can be changed directly to vary the output. It is recommended to use a constant current source rather than PWM dimming because PWM results in a fast-varying, non-stable light intensity, as previously mentioned. With both PWM and the 60 Hz wall supply, if the sensor integration time spans many periods of the oscillation, then this setup may be okay for quick tests. However, a stable DC source is preferred. We have now developed a simple setup for measuring accuracy and linearity using a stable light source, a reference meter, and an enclosure. This setup can be extended to measure accuracy over many conditions, such as temperature, near IR light level, or light source type. We will now explore one such example of utilizing this setup to measure accuracy over light source type. Different light sources have different spectra, as shown for LED, incandescent, and CFL. And this can affect the light sensor accuracy. This is specified as the light source variation spec mentioned in the previous chapter. Cover glass and other materials in front of the sensor can distort the light and amplify this error. Since this distortion is dependent on system integration, it is another example of a spec commonly tested using a prototype system in the lab. By taking measurements using different light sources in our test setup, we can determine variation. The lux meter is used as a reference to account for differences between the sources, such as differences in intensity. Common light bulbs work well for this test as they are readily available in all bulb types. Using a screw-in bulb socket mounted in the setup, the bulb can be swapped with minimal changes to the setup. Light source stability and uniformity should be noted for each light source, as mentioned previously. For example, different bulbs will take different amounts of time to thermally stabilize and will have different uniformity. Using common light bulbs and a socket may mean that the source is powered by the wall outlet supply. In this case, a long enough integration time should be used on both the light sensor and the lux meter to ensure impact on the measurement is minimized. Here is an example light source variation measurement. With a LED source, the sensor and meter read 505 and 500 lux. But with a CFL bulb, the sensor and meter read 320 and 300 lux. In this case, the accuracy with the LED has a 1% error, but with a CFL bulb, the error changes to 6.7%. The light source variation between these two sources is calculated as shown. We will now cover another example test setup, this time for field of view. Field of view, as mentioned in the previous chapter, indicates how much light is attenuated as the angle of incidence is increased. The system often has a hole or cutout in the product case to let light in, and this impacts the field of view of the system. Light pipes, lenses, and diffusers further alter field of view. While these effects can be estimated, it is an important parameter to measure to confirm results. As mentioned in the previous chapter, the optimal field of view is different for different applications. To measure the field of view, a test is run to determine the angular response of the system. As mentioned in the previous chapter, and seen in the angular response plot shown, field of view is the angle at which the response reaches 50%. To measure angular response, the response of the sensor is recorded with the light source at different angles relative to the sensor. To do this, either the light source must orbit the sensor, or the sensor must turn relative to the source. A simpler way to perform this test is to rotate the unit relative to the light source as shown. The angle relative to the source should be noted and the sensor reading recorded at each angle. Similar to the previous setups, the light source needs to be stable and an enclosure or darkroom used to remove ambient light. As this test is relative to the reading at 0 degrees, a reference is not needed if the light source is stable over time. In this test, the angle of incidence of the light is particularly important. Reflections off the wall of the enclosure will create light entering the sensor at undesired angles, and so must be minimized. The best way to do this is to place any walls far away by using a large enclosure or performing the test in a room with no lights or windows. Low reflectivity black materials, such as foam or fabric, may also be used to combat reflections. In this video, we have covered a number of setups for testing light sensors, including accuracy, linearity, source variation, and field of view. In some cases, such as when the sensor is placed behind a dark glass, performance will be greatly affected and calibration may be required. Calibration is the topic of the next video. To find more light sensor technical resources and to search TI products, please visit the link shown. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Please try the following quiz. Why do we compensate for the difference between the lux meter measurements and the sensor measurements during testing? The correct answer is A. Light sources typically have low uniformity, so compensation accounts for the spatial difference between the sensor and the meter.